Hello friends, friends of the textile industry, and especially the friends of technical textile industry. All of you are most welcome to one of the most enterprising sessions throughout the Tech Textile 2021, Sustainable Technical Textiles. You would obviously say sustainability and technical textile, how does that rhyme? Very difficult to believe, because over the years we have seen that technical textiles mainly depend on synthetic fibers, polymers, and a lot of other raw materials which are not organic, or leave alone organic, not even natural. So how does these words go together, sustainability and technical textiles? But dear friends, sustainability is the flavor of the world right now. And post-pandemic, post-COVID-19, people have got more and more aware about the importance of immunity, sustainability, going back to nature, climate change, global warming. What was happening once in a decade or once in a century is happening every year, that we are seeing around everywhere, may it be India, China, any part of Asia or Europe. So being responsible is the need of the hour, and definitely being sustainable is the need of the hour. So can we link somehow sustainability and technical textile is what we are going to explore during this 45-minute session today. So most welcome all of you again. And I would like you to introduce all of you to our very, very reputed and experienced guests that we have today, the panelists with me. First, let me introduce myself, a brief introduction. This is Manish Daga from the Cotton Guru Group. We are into agriculture and textile since over a century. Started in 1903, fifth generation, currently in business. We are into agriculture as well as processing of cotton and also in export of cotton. We have a farmer producer company federation, which has over 100 farmer producer companies as their members and a direct network of over 1 lakh farmers. Sustainable farming, yes, we are doing that since over a decade, and we are engaging the corporates. Our dream in Cotton Guru is to unlock the socio-economic potential of agriculture for global prosperity. That is the mission that drives us. And the dream that we have recently started seeing is bringing fashion to farm. Is it possible to get the fashion trends come down to the farm and for them to then make a vision statement that how can they link the farmers to the brands? So a lot of farms are being developed on those bases. A lot of brands are engaging, especially in sustainable agriculture and regenerative agriculture. So this is what Cotton Guru stands for. Now, for our most experienced and expert panel speakers today, see Suresh Bhai Kotak, the Bhishma Pitama of cotton textile industry. He knows everything that is to be known about cotton. He has experienced everything that is to be experienced in cotton textile industry. And his vision is, of course, what I would all of you like to know here upfront and live from him. That is Shri Suresh Bhai Kotak from Kotak Group of Companies, and his experience and expertise and his vision is unparalleled in the cotton textile industry. So he is one of our panel expert speakers. Second is Shri Avinash Mahekar. He's into projects Suvin Advisors, this is company, and they have been doing a lot of projects on textiles and recently on technical textiles. And he himself stands for, something that walk the talk, something like they deliver on time. They have a very, very high regard for efficiency and for integrity. And his group definitely stands for something that we can say that a link for the industry to get started in India. So that is Shri Avinash Mahekar. Our third, welcome Avinashi. Our third expert speaker is Shri Prashant Verma. Prashant is from Kamla Tech. He's a consultant. He is a gold medalist and a master's from IIT. And he has done a lot of work in fiber science. he has rich experience in the industry, and now he is sharing that experience, exploring new opportunities in technical textile by consulting industries on innovations in fibers and other raw materials. So most welcome to you, Prashant bhai. Yeah, Prashant ji, most welcome to you.
Thank you, sir.
Right. So, Suresh bhai, before I start with you, let me just share some insights on technical textiles with our listeners of this Tech Textile Sustainable Technical Textile session today. The technical textiles are engineered products with a definite functionality. They are manufactured, of course, using natural as well as synthetic fibers, man-made fibers, which exhibit enhanced functional properties. Natural fibers which are used in technical textiles are cotton, bamboo, silk, jute, banana, silk, etc. Unlike the conventional industry in India, which is highly export intensive, the technical textile industry is still import dependent. Products such as diapers, polypropylene, spun bond fabric for disposables, wipes, protective clothing, hoses, webbings, they form a substantial part of the country's imports. That is, India imports a lot of these raw materials. In India, production is largely concentrated in small scale segments such as canvas, tarpaulin, carpet backing, woven sacks, etc. That is where we need to improvise, improve and explore more opportunities. The technical textile sector in India is heavily dependent on import of specialty fibers, which are about 30% component of the raw material. And India relies heavily on importing this specialty fibers owing to an increase in demand, but lack of requisite technology and R&D in this segment. Moreover, fiscal anomalies such as imposition of excise duties on raw material and no exemption on the finished product have escalated the overall cost of the technical textile industry and discouraged domestic production in these raw materials. Products such as tarpaulins, jute carpet, fish nets are the main areas where India stands out in export, but all of these do not require much R&D. So products which require R&D, India is still lagging behind. That was what is the outcome of the 10-year story of the technical textile industry in India. So India's strength have always been defined in traditional textiles and natural fibers. India is the number one producer of cotton since many years, number two exporter of cotton since many years. So we are a cotton surplus country, basically, both in conventional and organic. In fact, in organic cotton, India is 50%. India has 50% market share in export. So is there any way we can reduce the current pain of the technical textile industry as far as raw material, this raw material availability and cost is concerned? And can we make a new roadmap to escalate the growth of the technical textile industry? That would be our core intention of this session. I invite you, Suresh bhai. Suresh bhai?
Yes, bolo.
Haji, most welcome, sir. You have been advocating the use of natural fibers and other innovations of blends in technical textiles since many years. So kindly share your views. What can be the new opportunity for the technical textile industry?
Well, you see, there are two things.
Yeah.
Basically, we must understand what is basically technical textiles. The basically technical textiles are addressed to the functionality of the use. Functionality and the use is with functionality, and it is different than what is the apparel industry requires. So we must find out on both ends the functionality and the use, and some of the functionalities which are taken care by other materials, whether any of this renewable fibers, because basically natural fibers are renewable resources, right. And the world which has scarce resources, or the resources which are environmental damaging. The environmental damaging, plastic has been proved to be environmentally damaging. So the damage has to be manage, and it has to be worked out in a different way by the innovations. So we have to work in two directions, and there are a number of opportunities, which of course many industries have started finding. With studying different 70 kinds of fiber, say for example, in natural fiber, there are a number of fibers which can be used. Say, let us see, illustration, jute. Now jute, if you use a coating of Damar, what is Damar's English? I do not know. It is Damar.
Tar. Cement tar.
It will become an excellent geotextile material.
Okay.
So this use has been done. Now it is highly natural. Whereas polyester may be more enduring, but the point is the use of jute in this industry can be functional and specific. So this is only one example. So we have to explore. We have really not explored our high availability of natural raw materials, Lingi fibers, or say, for example, even in cotton to cotton. Even in cotton to cotton, I don't know how many people are aware. Perhaps Mr. Prashant may be aware because he has got an expertise in the fiber. You see, the cellulosic material out of cotton, even linter. Now, out of the linter, Sarcot has worked out kind of cellulosic, nano-cellulosic fibers, which is capable for at least 20 more functional uses. And if you see the nano-cellulosic plant of Sarcot and the kind of the derivatives, and they have found out that even the cellulosic linter out of the cotton residue can be as powerful as cement.
Yeah.
If you see that plant, it is as powerful as cement. So the question is, we are not studying our natural fibers to our advantage, and India is rich in natural fibers. Now, Loyal Textile has worked out a number of things out of the natural fibers. Arvind is doing the same thing. Arvind is using the advantage of cotton through innovations in the functionalities. Now, there are so many functionalities which can work out. Basically, all the technical fibers today are divided into 12 different sectors. Now, they are also broad. But say, for example, medical textiles. Medical textiles, cotton is preeminent fiber which can be used. Cotton's absorbency, super absorbency, has not been used. Dr. Thaley has made so many experiments by coating with cotton. You can create a highly functional repellent fiber. So the question is, how we use it? Then the blend with cotton and hemp, cotton and jute, different functions can be located and worked out. So the question is, what do we do? So even packaging. In packaging, you can work out a number of things. Coir. Now, coir is a fiber, fruit fiber. Now, coir has already been used in Germany, at least in 20 industries. India is only believing in exports. Our linters are also being exported. So we really do not go for real explorations of natural fiber. India can be very rich. Our agriculture is strong, but our innovation is weak. And our minds are closed, and our minds are so much traditional bounded and commercial bounded. Kya bhi isme kya karne ka hai, itna kya ho karne ka. Arre bhai, see, you have to work out all this thing. These are the small points. I can go on giving many thinking about this. Now, bamboo fiber, for example. Now, bamboo fiber is a medicinal fiber, insecticide. Now, bamboo fiber हैज प्रूव टू बी पग में और वेन में हो जाता है, उसको कुछ कहते हैं, उसके अंदर दे हैव टू पुट ऑन दी दिस बाम्बू फाइबर, बाम्बू फाइबर मटीरियल, सो ऑल वेरियस काइंड्स ऑफ थिंग्स कैन बी वर्कड आउट. बाम्बू इज वेरी रिच, बाम्बू कैन बी इवन फॉर ईटिंग, बाम्बूज बाम्बू शूट्स आर बींग यूज फॉर ईटिंग. सो द क्वेश्चन इज वेरियस काइंड ऑफ फाइबर्स विथ वेरियस काइंड ऑफ फंक्शनैलिटी. नाउ आई नो अबाउट सीमा, इन सीमा CDCDRA दे वर्कड आउट अ फाइबर विच हैज अ टेंसाइल स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ 50. Tensile strength of 50 means which is a replica of J34, and with that they are not utilizing. They say who will buy? They don't know who will buy. Sarcot has researches, 39 researches already listed, patented, out of cotton, not being utilized commercially. So the question is our entrepreneurial approach is weak, our innovative approach is weak, our utilization thinking and all this is very, very with small minded and small thinking. We can do a lot.
Thank you, Suresh Bhai. That was a very, very insightful statement from somebody who's looking at the world from a holistic approach. He's looking at so much innovation is already happening around the world. We have a rich resource of centers of excellence, research centers, renowned scientists across India. He's already named some. So what is wrong? Why is that experiment or why is that success or patent which has been done in the laboratory not being still brought out to the industry? Why is still there a gap? Let us ask this question to Avinash Ji. Avinash Ji, good afternoon.
Very good afternoon. How are you?
Absolutely fine, Avinash Bhai. Thank you. And please tell us something about the new projects that are happening in technical textiles. What is the flavor of the industry, or what are they actually looking for and doing on the field?
Yeah. Actually speaking, I will just take clue from Suresh Bhai. What he has said is that natural resources are available, abundantly available in India. What we are looking for, we are saying always that 90% of the technical textiles are synthetic fibers. No, we need to replace, we need to go ahead and understand the way he has said that, innovation. Lot many innovations are happening at laboratory scale, but they need to be implemented in the industry. For that, what is important is that I think the topic itself is the sustainability. So we need to be sustainable, then we need to have the fibers which are natural, which will take care of the environment, which are green textiles. At the same time, we are not going to pollute the environment. For this, cotton is the best fiber. Of course, Suresh Bhai has also mentioned about the jute. We have done a lot of research on jute for needle punching, and it was successful, not for the products which are going to be commercialized, but for products like mulch mat or for agro textiles. You can very well use jute fibers. So there are many indications. Even viscose is the one of the best fiber which can be used for absorbency. But as Suresh Bhai has said, cotton also is not that far away from absorbency as far as hygiene products are concerned. But when I have taken trials in Europe, I understood that these people, they don't understand cotton. Bleaching of cotton, which is a very simple thing, is not been understood by them. That's why they were not processing ahead for the spunless technology. Whereas with spunless technology, any type of natural fiber can be blended together with the properties which are there and then going ahead with the application. So what we do, we say that no, somebody has used viscose, that's why I should use viscose. But no, now world is changing. You must have seen that lot many ads which are coming up. They are saying that cotton rich, either feminine hygiene products or baby diaper products, they say cotton rich, but actually it is not cotton rich. They are just using one layer of cotton which is touching to the skin, and that's where we have to catch this, that yes, there is a big demand for cotton, but we are not utilizing it. Why other all layers cannot be of some other fibers which can be coated, laminated, or by using different technologies we can use them, and then we can go ahead. Coming to your question of number of projects, almost 3,000 projects are listed with the government for the technical textiles, and many more are in pipeline. But if at all I whenever I am in market, usually my customers ask him, Avinash bhai, tell us where we should go, what type of project we should put. I said, no, this is not the question to be asked. Whatever touches to your heart that you should come out with, I can tell you that what are your strengths. I can tell you how is the market demand. I can tell you how is the technology driving the force in the international market, in the local market, as well as whatever you are thinking of in that particular region. Accordingly, you need to have your product mix, you need to have your technology, and we can guide you for the implementation of the project. But they always go ahead and ask this particular question. I think that mentality of all our innovative, you know, entrepreneurs needs to be changed. They should understand that what is there in that particular region where they want to put up the project, or what are the, you know, metrics, for example, logistic cost, or for example, raw material cost, availability or nearness to the ports. All these things needs to be studied. At the same time, what is there for me? How I can be different? What innovation I am bringing in on the table by which I can produce this particular technical textile? Because as you all of us are aware, technical textiles are functional textiles. They are not that something you need to produce. You should understand first what are their, you know, end use, why it should be. If at all we are talking of absorbency, if at all we are talking of the porosity, what is the use, and then you have to select the technology and come out with the product. So number of projects, almost now we are going with 18 to 20% you know, CAGR every year. India is progressing quite well in technical textiles, but this needs of innovation, and as Suresh ji has rightly said, you know, use of natural fibers, and I would say substitute whatever products which are there. I think that's the key thing. Over to you, Manish.
Yeah. Thank you, Avinash bhai. He's given another twist to the tale that, yes, natural products are interesting, but the mindset of the industry is also that much more important. The focus, that the vision, the dream that the industry carries, it should not be what others are doing. Let me continue doing that. What difference can I make to this industry, to this world, and of course to my balance sheet? Is all that is important. And yes, Avinash, people, experts like Avinash bhai are there to guide them. Thank you, Avinash bhai. I will come back to you now. Going to our third expert speaker, Prashant bhai.
Yes, sir.
Most welcome.
Thank you, sir. Thanks for the opportunity.
Your smile is very mesmerizing, huh? Kindly share your current scope of work in technical textiles, because you have done extremely well in academics. You have had a rich experience, Prashant bhai. What are you currently doing in technical textiles, especially on the fiber side?
Yes, sir. First of all, namaskaram and good afternoon to every viewer here. And the opportunity I got after my education was into the technical textiles. So that was a good thing. I had worked with Arvind for starting up their advanced material division. I think it's a well-known division now. And worked with filtration fabrics. This was filtration fabrics for liquid solid filtration. Worked with glass fabrics for reinforcement. Worked with bulletproof fabrics. So pararamids for bulletproof application and all. These are the few fabrics. A lot of applications where we used conveyors, conveyor belts, fabrics. Also, I have worked partly with Nirjaf in Kolkata. So that's the Institute for Jute Research. So I was there for a year or so and worked on some of the technical textiles that's also being produced by Jute. So a lot of technical textile work being done in that arena. And post that, I have worked with Honeywell into the domains of personal protection. So almost all the technical textiles which are used for personal protections, and there's a center of excellence now in Hyderabad, which we should say actually it's a good thing that the Indian center of excellence provide the technical support to the US market and the Europe market. So that's a good thing. So these are the arenas where I have worked with in my career. And a new technology which is upcoming and which is also an interesting thing is the e-textile and the smart textiles. Which is actually a little bit nascent in India, but a lot of work has been done in US and Europe. So that's where from past 3 years, my expertise are also lying.
Right. So any other innovation happening right now? Because you are consulting, you also have had experience, you have academic expertise also. So anything new that is happening right now, which is really exciting you?
Yes. So to add a perspective to this discussion, basically in technical textiles, the things do lag. When I say lag in the sense is that when things start to happen, new things start to come in the apparel segment, when the sustainability was at a peak topic in apparel segment, it was not so much in technical textile, but now this is also getting into the technical textile segment and people are talking about it. I've recently been to an exhibition in Germany and a lot of people are using sustainability as a theme for their products. So basically, when we talk about sustainability in technical textiles, there are major four areas. The first one would be the product design itself, how you design the product. Second one is basically the manufacturing, which I believe to a lot of extent, people have taken control of that and are doing a lot of things in terms of reducing the carbon footprint and the emission. Third one is the use. Use again comes to best practices for between you and me and awareness. And the fourth one is disposal. The disposal is an area which again is lacking a bit in terms of the guidelines which are there. See, just putting two dustbins, one blue and one green, is not going to solve this kind of problem. So that's also a big problem there. And again, the product design will decide the disposal also. These are the four major aspects here. Now, coming to the innovations in this field, you see natural fibers like cotton are very much important in when you talk about something you want to wear. So any kind of a protective clothing, when we talk about protective clothing, cotton fiber becomes a very important fiber, which is again from a natural resource. But then what we do, let's say we talk about flame retardant protection. So we have some chemistry that is involved into the, which is put on top of the fabric, cotton fabric, and then it becomes flame retardant. But again, this chemistry, at the end of the day, after the product is used, at the end of the product, the cotton will anyways biodegrade. It's biodegradable, so it will degrade away. But this chemistry, if it's going to a landfill or it somehow is getting into your water, it's going to create a big issue. So what is the possibility on this side? So, and I have seen again, sir was talking about Sircot and all, and I believe there's a research from Sircot itself. So what they have done is they are using the banana fiber stems. So the extract from the banana fiber stems they are using, and they have a flame retardant properties. One of my clients was also very much interested. They wanted to create a kind of a green flame retardant fabric. But then the issue is that the durability and those things. So that work is still lagging. And I believe the connecting link which is actually missing here is the working of these circuits and these research institute along with the industry, which is not happening at this moment for a simple reason also, that industry wants business and money. That's basically what industries are for. And then again, there are some disconnects in the research arena also in terms of the pace at which they do and deliver. So these are some of the few issues. But yeah, there is a lot of innovation happening. People are trying to use fibers which are having low carbon footprints, like hemp fiber. So a lot of people are now blending hemp fiber in. So in apparel, it's already there. In technical textile, people are using it. Hemp fiber again is a fiber which is having high tenacity, a very very low carbon footprint. But again, the issue in India is that cultivation is only possible in a couple of states. So we are heavily dependent on imports. So that is one arena. Sisal fiber again, completely imported from Africa. But you see a lot of good products being done in southern part of India and Kerala. If you go, beautiful carpets, beautiful wall coverings, and great products are there. So I would say, and again, I met some of my customers are there working in natural fiber. They are also eager to develop something in terms of new innovative products from natural fiber. But then their disconnect is in terms of how and where we do and to whom we approach, because we don't know the chemistry part, or we don't know the XYZ part. We don't know the spinning part and all the parts. So this disconnect is also there in the industry.
Right, right. Yeah, Prashant bhai, very well explained the fact that the opportunities are there. We have access to products and technology, but the issue is who would be the right link or the right bridge, you know, which can be trusted and then relied upon till the completion of the project. Now, coming back to you, Avinash bhai, Prashant bhai said that industry wants to do business, industry wants to make money. So that should, of course, always be there. But is it important that the industry has to also analyze and evaluate the times ahead to catch the market trend before the fruit has ripened?
Of course. In fact, if you see the way things are happening, if at all I want to invest, I would always see that I should invest into something which is innovative, which is, you know, ahead of the times. That's not happening. What we are doing, we are copying. We are having that herd mentality, maybe because British have ruled over us for so many years. But still now we have to come out. And interesting.
Others have ruled more, but British have influenced more.
Yeah. The thing is that we can have our own satellite, but we cannot have a simple ginning machine of ourselves. We cannot have a simple, you know, weaving machine of ourselves. We cannot have some good innovative processing machine of ourselves. How it is possible? If at all the same innovation is happening in the same country, why we are not able to, you know, encash on this? Other thing is that, you know, the sustainability itself. Because when we say that it has to be sustainable, it is not for me and you, Manish, but it is for the next generation. And my son would always see to it that, you know, even if he has to pay something more, he will opt for the sustainable product because he understands it, but you and me don't understand it. We know it, but we don't understand it. We don't practice it. Whereas this, the new generation is going to practice for it. So we need not say that, you know, carpet has to be from polypropylene. We need not say that, you know, this particular curtain has to be of polyester cotton. Why not 100% cotton? And as we were talking of cotton products, even the cotton bale itself is wrapped either in jute or in polypropylene nowadays. Why? Why not the cotton sheet itself will have the cotton bale coverage, which will be more, you know, regular without any contamination, and it will serve the purpose. And mind well, if at all there is a blend of technology and fiber, Mr. Prashant is coming from fiber science and I'm coming from technology background, if at all we blend this together, we can produce something which can be good for the industry. And market is for such type of products. We did not copy something. We did not say that we have to do this, we have to do that. What best I can do? What is future? How I can bring value to the future? And environment is going to be the plus point and always number one criteria for doing anything and everything. Second would be the technology. Third would be your raw material. So raw material itself is available with us. We have very good environment. Till date, there are no much of pollution in the entire country, except barring few, you know, major cities. But then why not to take care of this environment ourselves? Why not to come out with the products with innovation? Tell me one thing, Manish, that so many technology driven markets are there in Germany and, you know, France and in other countries. We don't have that. But how many Indians are going there and investing in R&D facilities? Because they hire these facilities for giving it on rent. How many of Indians are going there and doing some innovation? Hardly anybody. Even the big groups, they are doing something which is there in the market for so many years for the conventional textiles. But when it comes to innovation, it has to be for the technical textiles, functional textiles. How best I can utilize my resources and how I can safeguard my future of not only of my country or my generation, but for the generations to come. That's what needs to be done.
Right. So like Avinash just said that, yes, what we look at is importing the material. Can we not import the technology? Can we not invest in technology so that our profits become sustainable? We can tap the market of today, tomorrow, and day after tomorrow. We are looking at today's market. A technical textile industry takes 2 to 3 years, sometimes 5 years to set up. And by the time we are set up and in the market, the trend would have already been gone. Most probably because we are studying today's market. Are we ready for the market day after tomorrow when we actually launch our product? That is what is some strategic vision that the industry and of course the government has to deliberate upon, so that we achieve sustainability. People, planet, profit. That is sustainability. Only profits cannot be sustained. You have to cater to people. You have to cater to the planet because economics work that way. It is always economics, society, and environment. We stand together. And then the growth is sustainable. That is what history says. And we should always keep that in mind. All of you, I just met the Deputy Council General of Germany, Ms. Marja, yesterday during the textile event. And like you said, what she shared to me that, Cotton Guru, you should be focusing more on the younger generation. I said, ma'am, I'm into sustainable agriculture and building robust supply chain for the industry. Why the younger generation? They will understand the point better, she said.
That's true.
They will be ready to pay. They will be ready to engage. They will be ready to invest. And that is what, and she's not so young, but she looks at the young generation with such respect. And that is what we should also all appreciate about the younger generation. And thank you, Avinash bhai, for your views. Now, Prashant bhai, coming back to you, what would you feel is the most commercially successful innovation that has happened in the natural fibers in technical textile?
See, in natural textile, in natural fibers, and basically talking about cotton fibers, one of the big thing, I would not call it an innovation, but improvement is happening on that, is in terms of heavy fabrics made from cotton. They have been used in many applications and are still being used. They are being used for conveyor belts. They have been coated and being used in conveyor belts. And there are applications where you use them for what we call is a more sustainable print media. So these are something which are coming up new. So these more sustainable print media basically comes, use this cotton fabrics, and then they would have some kind of acrylic coating. Again, as I said, product design is important. Acrylic, something which may not be as sustainable or biodegradable, but yeah, again, we have to work on those things. So these are the things which are coming up, trying to replace that old PVC based kind of a product which generate a lot of waste, and it's also hazardous to the environment. So these are some of the few products which are coming up. Sir also mentioned about the new use of new technology, Suresh Bhai. So he's very correct on that. So a lot of new technologies are happening, and also research work being done in IITs where they have tried to make cotton. So the issue with cotton at many applications is that it's hydrophobic, and then it will absorb something. So then that moisture will create an issue and all. So they have created, they are working on research projects and created cottons which are super hydrophobic now. They have a lot of electrospinning based product where the natural antimicrobial finishes are coming from chitosan and all these things. And these have been electrospun into nanofibers. A lot of if you see medical field, lot of this synthetic parts or any components in the body are also being made through the process of electrospinning. So it's biomedical engineering. There also there's a lot of scope of using this natural material, getting it dissolved into the cellular level, and then again re-engineering it into a different formation where it was not there from the nature. This formation, you are designing the formation, and then where, as sir was mentioning, you get the desired strength or you get the desired functionality embedded in that core of this kind of a fiber. So these are the few things which are happening in the arena. But yeah, commercially, if we talk about, then these are the product which I mentioned, said beltings and then geotextiles and all. These are the product where this jute and cotton, these natural fibers are being used commercially.
Right. Thank you.
Yeah, in fact, sorry, Manish, to come in.
No, please.
If at all you see, yeah, the cost of production depends on not only raw material, but also it depends on so many factors. So if at all you want 400 GSM for a particular application, I can produce 350 GSM cotton fabric. I can coat it the way Mr. Prashant was saying. I can coat it, or I can laminate it, or I can just, you know, add on some features by which it can serve the purpose. So cost of production is not the criteria. It can be produced, it can be innovated. But that's what I was saying, that in order to bring in, you know, cost of production down, you need to do a lot of innovation. And that's what is not happening. There are technology providers, we need to use those facilities.
Correct. We need utilize the resources. That is also part of a sustainable supply chain. Right. Yesterday, I met interesting gentleman during Tech Textile, all of you. He is working on absorbent, using the absorbency of cotton for oil spill. He says he has done a lot of experiments, and the synthetic fibers over the years have not proved to be a sustainable option. He is working on waxing cotton such that it will not absorb water. It will repel water, but it will absorb oil. And he said those experiments have been successful. Now he's looking at someone who can mass produce it for him. And that was his intention of visiting our stall yesterday in Tech Textile. So there are a lot of things happening. But yes, we need to engage people. We need to have a platform where people can come and share their pains, their achievements, their innovations. And then we can make a very strong network out of the group which comes together. So that is definitely an opportunity. Suresh Bhai? Coming back to you, sir, with your vision and with your, you know, years and years of experience, please tell us, can there be a policy, you know, which can be a kickstart for the exploration of using natural fibers in technical textiles?
In my opinion, it is a matter of functions. It is four-way. Aspected.
Okay.
My thinking is four-way aspected. Number one, we must identify the functions. As today's world demands that the functions are to be identified, and very rightly said, then we have to go backward that for this function, which natural fiber would be workable. So yes. Unless you know the output, the input, appropriate input, if that is the style taken in various innovation and various promotion, so this is the one thing which one should do. Say, for example, I will quote, I have been attending regular functions of engineered fibers, fiber engineering in USA. In cotton fiber engineering, Cotton Incorporated found out that the wipes, cotton wipes, can be a huge market. But what will be the function? Wipes are the function. Now cotton wipes became very popular. Now we did not go for function identification, but function came by itself. Even the mask that we use every day are all cotton, and China and all those produced the masses in the mass scale, and they got the money, and we were hesitant for all this. So the opportunity lies in identifying the functional identification, and then go backwards to find out which of our natural product, and as Avinash also said, which blends, which kind of layering, what would you do? So that kind of thinking must be a kind of a thinking which we must start with in our approach. So in cotton wipes, to give you the latest development, the cotton wipes are used with medicine of anti-malarial for anti-malarial prevention. So a function has been found. So our policy must contain this one aspect, the functional identification. Second, the idea and the definition of sustainability also needs to be little looked in a different way. I would consider the renewable resource, environment friendly resource, as one of the important aspects of sustainability. We define sustainability with different angle. That angle may be true, but added to that, the aspect, because ultimately understand that even let us say plastic may have multiple uses, but after all, it is a mineral resource, and mineral resources are not renewable, or if they are renewable at the end of a lot of great time. So even otherwise, it's a necessity. And if it's necessity is the mother of invention, is this not a necessity to the mankind just now? That this is the necessity, and the necessity is the mother of invention. So why do we not think about this as on today? Because we have realized, we have experienced, and we are all suffering from the damaging aspects of the plastics to the economy. And the polyester is nothing else but the plastic. Maybe it has many ductility, there are a number of advantages. But after all, is that sustainable? Really, it is not sustainable, but our understanding of sustainability is narrow. Let us widen it in terms of resources. So this should be number two. As I said, I have 4 points only. Number third, not only innovate. Now, innovate, say, for example, I have read that different kind of super hybridization, now, which I have had occasion to interact, super hybridization, say, for example, still has certain kind of inherent property. If it goes with cotton, it can become as strong as steel. This is what I have learned from one student of innovation in silk. So this such super hybridization should be a part of our innovation, and super hybridization can take place as super hybridization of different, as we have a hybridization in cotton itself, we must have this kind of super hybridization. The super hybridization can produce a lot of new materials of natural kind. This particular area is an amiss. Now, secondly, genomics. We are talking about design cotton. So I learned in engineering fibers that design cotton is a possibility. And such genomics is a wonderful science. And as I attend various genomics conferences in cotton, I have found that you can definitely create many, many kinds of new cotton fibers. So super hybridization and this kind of technology can be workable, can be aggregated, can be pulled together, and we can work out with the institution like VJTI. Now VJTI and Sarcot is doing applied thing, but people at VJTI should be encouraged. And finally, all this kind of approaches must be incentivized, very large incentivization to use our own resources, to use our own wealth, to utilize our and get into the bottom of our wealth and get it to the public, get it to the nation. We must incentivize in a broad way. So the whole thing should be projected out with by people like Avinash Bhai, who is a brain. So or such people, we can be only, I am a commercial man, we can find out ways how best to promote it. It can be promoted. Yeah, there are ways it can be promoted, but the focus of thinking of the government, and Avinash Bhai, you must take a lead. Cotton sure, sure. must take a lead, and we will become the followers to follow these four ideas. As money is a matter of functions four, this let us be a function of four. Thank you very much.
Yeah. Well, just one thing to add over here is that the petrochemicals themselves are under question mark. What is going to happen with electric cars coming in and, you know, a lot of innovation which is happening in that, you know, green world. So we need to be very cautious about it, that before the restriction comes, we should use our resources which are available with us, exactly. which are naturally available.
So sir, why don't you write a project on that?
Sure, I will do that.
Make a project, a project, Prashant ji, Mayakar ji.
Yeah, sure, sure.
You write a project and let us be the followers and the promoters of that.
Yeah, sure. So let us meet on our textile friends forum and share this project, and we will include Prashant Bhai also, and then we're going to, you know, share this project with the industry also. It would be a really a good outcome of today's session. Some questions I have received. We have only 3-4 minutes before we end our session. This what are your views regarding the new announcement of textile parks? Are they really going to work as far as the growth of technical textiles is concerned, and can sustainability be incorporated in any of them? View from all of you.
Textile park is a very good scheme. It was also a very good scheme earlier as well, not been practiced properly, and that's why it was on the wrong track. But if at all we want to compete on large scale with China especially, then we need to have this type of, you know, infrastructure which is ready, by which we can have, you know, scale of economy. That's it.
Right. Your view, Prashant Bhai?
I don't want to add much on to what Avinash ji has said, but I also want to point out something which was missing on the discussion. I just want to remember it, so just pointing it out. I think regulation is also a big deal here, because sustainability, again, we are getting into a trap where we are going to do all the things and then go to a European agency and say, you give me a certificate, I am sustainable or not. Why is India not generating anything sustainable? So I just wanted to add to that.
Correct. Perfect. We are already facing that pain in sustainable agriculture.
Right.
And everything, we have to go to Europe. Nice point, Prashant Bhai. Suresh Bhai, your views on the textile park?
Well, I think textile park is a good movement, but along with the textile park, we must also have a kind of a research laboratory on the materials they use. it should become, as Prashantji says, our regulation should include all that, that no place or no this thing without innovation or at least Kaizens. We have to use the Japanese Kaizens every moment. Unless we do the small and big victories together, along with the textile park, the textile park mere as a capital point of investment and facility have a value. But in order to do give it a the propelling ability, the propelling ability comes only through various kinds of inbuilt innovation available next block.
Sir, it is part of it actually. If you go by the textile policy, textile park policy, it is part of it. We need to have somebody who can put up that innovation center. Government is not going to put it up. So the park authority needs to have their own innovation center.
No, no, doesn't matter. But the kind of the initiative or incentive. The question is the textile park with innovations and laboratories and along with the, say, farm for actual experiment should be given further incentive.
Correct, correct. I agree with Suresh Bhai and also both of you, Avinash Bhai and Prashant Bhai, that something has to be done immediately. And now before we end the event today, some one or two views from our side in Cotton Guru, that we should have a benchmark to set up the textile park. Like we have Bolo Lemi or Hawassa in Ethiopia, we have Prato in Italy, we have integrated textile clusters in China. Even in India, we have Brandix India Apparel City in Vizag, which can be taken as case study to make such innovative and successful textile parks. More efforts will have to be made in the direction of fostering a well-developed R&D ecosystem. That is what we agreed on, to utilize the true potential of our centers of excellence. And we have to make optimum use of the natural fiber abundance that India has, and innovate in blends also to get over the pain of importing raw material, high cost raw material, and unlocking the potential of easy availability of sustainable raw material in India. That is all from all of us on this Tech Textile Forum of Sustainable Technical Textile. Best wishes to all of you from this entire team and Cotton Guru Parivar, all of you. Shubh Mangal Kamna.
Thank you very much.
I have one point if I'm allowed.
Yeah, Prashant Bhai, one
last. Yeah, just quickly before leaving. Sorry again. I just wanted to just tell the viewers that obviously, apart from the innovation which you are doing, please try to get the IP on that, because later on we would find that a lot of natural fiber based innovation, we would have to take license from somebody else and do that production here. And let us not let that situation happen. Thank you.
Excellent. Thank you. Let us not follow, but let us be followed. Correct.
Yeah. Let's innovate.
Let's innovate. Let's get together.